By the time I am on this stage, I think everything has been covered that I thought I would say. So that makes my job easier. And also, it's lunchtime now, half the people are outside, and those who are inside, I'm sure you're very hungry. So I will not really take much of your time. And this will be the only slide that you will see, because I feel this is the slide that says it all now. 40 years. So I come from an organization called HelpAge India, and as the name suggests, HelpAge India is an organization working for the senior citizens. And this is our 40th year, and I really feel privileged to be here amongst you talking about senior citizen issues and also a little bit about HelpAge India. So in this 40 years of HelpAge India's service to the senior citizens, especially the disadvantaged senior citizen, I have been working for the last 31 years. And in that 31 years, when I first joined, that is in 1987, people really never knew that old age is an issue. So what does your organization do? So then actually HelpAge used to work for the needy and disadvantaged older people, that is poorer people in the villages. But for the last decade and or so, the tagline, if you see, HelpAge India is fighting isolation, poverty, and neglect. And that says it all, because we found people questioning us and saying that old age is not only limited to the people who are poor and living in villages. In the city too, in the urban areas, people do have problem. Old age issues are becoming rampant. And we have a helpline where now we receive a whole lot of phone calls saying that, you know, they want to know about property related matters, about legal facilities that can be given to the senior citizen. So I will be very short and brief. For the few of you that who are present over here, today we are here because there are 100 million and maybe a little more now, or 10 crores of senior citizens in our country, and that is why this convention. And during the presentation, 60,000 people to whom the services, the aged care services are provided for, only for it to be viable and sustainable. So what happens to the rest? In the villages where, as I said, we first began our work, the community is the one that used to take care of the senior citizen. Over here, however much number of policies and act the government may bring out for the senior citizen, if the community does not become age friendly, I'm sure working here for the last 31 years that no real improvement or change in the quality of life or dignity will come into the lives of the people, older people, senior people. So, as I said, this is the only slide, the one and only slide, which will go to show that for this problem, which now people are waking up to, is because there are 100 million older people in India now. But 40 years back, HelpAge started work among the needy and the disadvantaged elderly people in the villages. Our work at that point of time was mainly welfare, but now we have transformed into welfare. We have a welfare component because there will be bedridden older people who will not be as much active as others. So there is a welfare component there. But also we are going on to shifting to development work, which means with the active elderly, especially this is a village model, where we have formed elder self-help group where they can be independent, self-sufficient. And we have a concept of elder for elders, where the active members of that group will look after the destitute, bedridden, and sick elderly people. So this has been talked about, joint family. Why today we need laws is because joint family system has broken down, and also more women are working full-time jobs. So the laws that are there is, there are first, this is the background, then policies, government came out with the policies. So in 1999, there was this national policy on senior citizen, which was revised in the year 2011. Then in 2005, there was protection of life and property of senior citizen. because it was found the senior citizen, especially living in cities, became easy target for a whole lot of criminal activities. So we see every day in the newspaper that they have been killed for money, and there have been a whole lot of abuses on them and crime on them. So after 2005 came the Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act, and I would request you to take notice of the word welfare. This welfare component was never there in previous Maintenance Act. This act is exclusively, I will just dwell on a few points on these acts. It is meant only for the senior citizens. It is not observed in the cases are not fought in the courts. There is a government tribunal for this Maintenance Act, and in the SDO, the subdivisional officer is the maintenance officer, and there is legal practitioners are barred because of maybe the older person will not be able to pay the fees. So the social welfare officer over here is the legal help that a senior citizen can take. And something that can interest people over here is this act was passed in the year 2007. So any transfer of property after 2007, after this act was passed, can be got back. The revocation of property, the clause is the revocation of property, gone back, gets the senior person gets back the property, because it has always been conditional that when a senior citizen is giving wealth or property for their maintenance, and if they're not looked after, sometimes it happens that they make them sign and then they are turned out of the house. So in that case, they will get back their property. And this is a fast track court where within 3 months, the case has to be disposed of. So after getting the notice, within 3 months, the case has to be disposed of. So these are the certain features of this act. And since no lawyer is necessary, there's no going to court, it's the government tribunal. One can go and report to the police station, their nearby police station, if it is in the city area, or in the SDO office, if it is outside the city, and they can always be helped by them. A simple application form will be given, and then the notice will go to all their children. So another thing is that there are also, like I see pronoun is a pronoun name over here. In Salt Lake, the Bidhan Nagar police has come out with another helpline for the elderly. It is called Shanjbati. Similarly, Orpon is a helpline in Barakpur. And Orpon and Shajbati is being done with another organization, NGO, called Offer. So in conjunction with Offer, there are two elderly helplines under the Bidhan Nagar Commissionerate and Barakpur Commissionerate. So this is a part of the information. And the other thing is, there are two important days. These are awareness days. One is 15 June, which is World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. And the other is 1st October. This is, of course, the celebration for senior citizen. It's the Senior Citizens Day. So we call it the International Day of Older Person. And both the days have been mentioned by, has been marked by, in fact, the United Nations. So to bring global awareness of the problems and issues of the elderly. And I can say that with a lot of advocacy on behalf of HelpAge, the government of West Bengal has been observing these two dates, 15 June, World Elder Abuse Awareness Day, and 1st October. But while I'm talking about Maintenance Act, to go back to that act, although it is talking about maintenance, but there are no strict rules on elder abuse and how this law can help an elderly person who is subject to abuse. And the other thing is, although this act is about the welfare of the senior citizen, they have the West Bengal rules under this act. Somebody was talking about old age home, I think Digonto, and there are, I think Mr. Mukherjee had asked that what are the standards of operation. In the Maintenance and Welfare Act 2007, certain standards of operation by the to be maintained by HelpAge, I'm sorry, the old age home has been given. So I think if these standards are followed, which was not there previously before 2007, and there have been many homes before 2007, then it is a good standard to maintain, and then there should be no problem either legally or otherwise. I want to end my presentation over here, and thank you so much.